The good thing about fungal acne is that it's not hard to treat once you've identified that it is actually fungal acne. Yes, it can look a lot like normal acne, but this video, we will go over how to know straight away that it's fungal acne, the causes of fungal acne and how you can prevent it from coming back, because that is an issue, and most importantly, how to get rid of fungal acne fast. Definitely stay tuned till the end of the video as I'll also be going over one tip that will speed up things even faster. Hi guys, you've seen us on Media Pharmacist here on YouTube. If you guys want to learn more about making informed decisions about your health and wellness in an easy to understand way, and if you haven't already subscribed, then I'd love for you all to click that red subscribe button down below. Also give this video a like if you enjoy learning about topics like these. Now let's not waste any more time, let's get straight away into what is fungal acne. Fungal acne is actually the result of an overgrowth of yeast, otherwise known as Malassezia Folliculitis. It's actually a folliculitis, which is basically an infection of the tiny hair follicles on the face or body, which leads to papules that are small raised solid bumps that look a lot like pimples. You see, the sebaceous glands within your skin produce an oil called sebum. When they overproduce oil, the pores can get clogged with oil, as well as bacteria and yeast that are actually normally found on the skin itself. The bacteria can lead to the traditional acne blemishes, but the yeast can cause an inflammation of the hair follicles known as folliculitis. And the easiest way to distinguish them is if they're actually itchy. Fungal acne is itchy but never painful, and they flare up when it gets hot or when you start sweating, especially if it's on the back. Now that we got through what fungal acne is, I think it's also important to know how it forms so you can take the necessary steps to prevent them from coming back. The first contributing cause of fungal acne is heat and humidity. Fungal acne is more prevalent in hotter climates and in areas of the world where the weather is always warm. This is what makes it a perfect climate for the yeast to thrive. The second is sweat. A big mistake when it comes to fungal acne is actually not changing out your yoga clothes or your workout clothes when you finish, especially hot yoga. It is not ideal to sit around in sweaty clothes as this can cause sweat-induced fungal acne. The third is long-term use of topical antibiotics for acne. This is because the yeasts on our skin are part of our microbiome, right? And they're okay to have when they are in normal amounts. But with the antibiotics attacking all the bacteria and not the yeast, the yeast end up surviving and flourishing more than the bacteria, causing inflammation and fungal acne. Now that we got through what fungal acne is, how it is formed, let's finally address the treatment. And that's probably what you're here anyway. The good news is, let me remind you, that it's not difficult to treat it. The first method you could try, and also one of my favorite ones, is the Nizoral Anti-Dandruff Shampoo. Apply it, let it sit, and lather it up, and wait about 15 minutes before washing it off. Apply it twice a day for 2 to 3 weeks to see full results. If that doesn't work, you could try Clotrimazole cream, which is a cream used in athlete's foot. Same thing, apply it twice daily to the fungal acne for 2 to 3 weeks to see the results. These two methods have worked tremendously for some to get rid of the fungal acne altogether, but I've also mentioned that I leave you with one last tip to get rid of them even faster, which is to dilute 1 to 2 drops of tea tree oil with 12 drops of a carrier oil of your choice. It could be olive oil, and apply it topically around the fungal acne. Make sure to do a patch test first to make sure you aren't allergic to tea tree oil. But really guys, the terpene 4 oil in the tea tree oil promotes anti-inflammatory cytokine production while also stopping pro-inflammatory cytokine expression. So in a nutshell, that will help with the swelling and the itching to help speed up the recovery process of fungal acne. Click the red subscribe button and let me know what your thoughts are down below. Also guys, give this video a like so I know that you did enjoy it. And if you want me to go over any other condition, let me know as I'd be happy to take suggestions. And until then guys, I'll see you on the next one.